It's a kind of spiritual experience for somebody like me to have the opportunity to sort of see what a Latter-day Saint temple is like.
I don't know how to speak about heaven in the traditional, lovely, paradisiacal beauty that we speak of heaven. I wouldn't know how to speak of heaven without my wife or my children. It would not be heaven for me. Now, you can say that's wishful thinking. Or you can say that's just because you love each other and you've gotten cozy here on earth and you like each other's company. It's a lot more than that. There is something eternal in the statement that neither is the man without the woman nor the woman without the man in the Lord. That isn't just good sociology. That is theology. It's eternal. First aid. We all need an infusion every now and again. We all need hope and help and holiness. And the temple does all of that for me.
Often members of the church will go to the temple with the very vexing problem that they have no idea what they'll do with it. And as they go to the temple and go through the ceremonies there, then it's as the scriptures say, the voice of the Lord comes into their mind, and what was not solvable becomes solvable.
We're able to do that because Jesus is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. This is his church, and those are his temples, and he is all that we declare him to be, the light and the life of the world.